Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Van Aan & Company. It's Friday, February 15th. I'm going to go over the markets with you for the day and week here. So corn market really struggling here to do anything. It was steady on the day and up half a cent on the week, so very limited movement there. Beans and wheat had a little bit of a negative trend this week, except for Minneapolis wheat. But bean market up for today. It kind of reversed itself after a friendly NOPA crush came out at 11 o'clock. But overall on the week, down 7 cents. Wheat market, Chicago wheat down 2 3/4 today. Down 13 cents on the week. Kansas City down 5 cents today, down 17 3/4 on the week. So that's a really ugly print when you look at that. A lot of negativity when you look at the wheat complex. We're not quite sure where managed money is. We're still delayed on that, but it'll be interesting to see if they're aggressively selling this wheat complex. The Minneapolis wheat was the only one that was able to find some support and separate itself. Down 2 1/4 today, but overall on the week up 4 1/2 cents. You now have just over halfway through February insurance pricing, and we're at 401 for corn, 956 for beans, and 584 for wheat. So those are so far what we've been calculating. The further we get in, the less likely they are going to change without a very large swing here into the market. Rumors around are just that trade talks have been going good, that President Xi said that they will extend these talks to Washington here next week. There's been a few rumors out there that President Trump is maybe looking to extend the deadline by 60 days. That's still not quite sure if that's going to happen or not, just some rumors out there. You did see him actually sign the agreement between the House and Senate for funding the government with some border security, and then he called a national disaster and came in to get some more funding here for the southern border here into the U.S. And so that got the Dow up and running, up over 300 points today, up over 700 points for the week. Crude oil had a big day today as well, up just over $1 and up over 250 on the week. Meat markets had a little bit of separation here. Live cattle, feeder cattle weaker on the futures market. Cash trade was actually steady to slightly higher though. So on the week, live cattle down 75 cents, feeders down $1.50. They were a little bit negative here today. And then when you look at the hog market, up 82 1/2 cents today. When you look at the week, you are switching from the Feb to April contract. So on the chart, it looks like a bigger gain than it was, but the April contract just over a dollar higher here on the week. Cash trade came in 125 to 127 live, 200 to 205 dressed. And then cash hogs have really been flat around that $58 mark. Moving forward, what we're going to be watching is next week offers a lot of details, especially when you look at those export sales. We are off on Friday or on Monday for President's Day. No grain trade there, no meat trade. But then you get that push back here to Friday. Then for export sales, that's 6 weeks worth of sales. We will be up to date to see what happened. We had very ugly ones this week, so a lot of eyes will be looking at that, and we'll be watching what comes out of trade talks. I do have to close with a disclaimer. Trading in futures and options involves risk loss and is not suitable for all producers. This is a solicitation. Have a great weekend.